So what I'm going to discuss today, so we want to do one project actually. So this project is going to be like, so in real time, when you are going to work with any client, let's take today, I'm going to work with Heritage. Let's take Heritage Supermarket. Okay. So you know, like what is Heritage will do? So what the Heritage will do? Only milk products. Okay, I think recently the Heritage Groups has sold out by Future Groups. Future Groups of companies. Heritage has a supermarket also. Everyone knows about, right? So Heritage has a supermarket as well. So in that supermarkets, they are going to sell all the products. So they have different stores, and inside the stores you are a customer, and when you are going to the Heritage supermarket, then there are a lot of products are there in their store, and you are bringing a product, correct? And that products immediately you are going to purchase, you will make a transaction. This is very well known process to everyone. So when you are going to do a transaction, what will happen when they are going to start this business? Heritage or anyone. So this is their stall. For example, this is a supermarket, store 1, store 2, store 3. Across they have so many stores. In each store they have different billing counters. Counter 1, counter 2, counter 1, counter 2. This is how they have different counters. You are a customer and you will go to the store and you will find out the product. With that product you will go to the billing counter. Inside the billing counter, there is some cashier or someone will be standing in front of the application computer. Inside that computer, you can see there is a billing application, correct? So that billing application developed by someone, some other company. It's like by using a Java, .NET or web application, anything. It might be a CRM application, customer relation management application, or it might be a Salesforce, whatever they are using, it's none of our business. It's none of a matter, okay? Because we are not going to develop that one. Heritage has started this business 10 years back. So that time they developed this application, okay? So in that application, when they are entering all these details, what are the products, what are all the... So definitely, all that products information they should have in their database already, correct? What are all the products they are going to sell? What are all the products they are going to sell? And what are all the categories, what are all the different subcategories, and what is the locations they have their stores, and also what are all the colors or each product specifications. It's all related to the their inventory. We can say it's a like stock or inventory. So that information already existing in a backend database. So inside this, where you are going to store this database, that I'm going to use a SQL server. So Microsoft SQL Server. And similar to SQL Server, we have other RDBMSs like Oracle, MySQL, DB2. So anything they can use, because it's a 10 years back. Heritage has, that time, the IT partner, they have given to Wipro or Infosys. What they are suggesting? They are suggesting to develop an application, .NET. They are suggesting in the backend database as a SQL Server, because .NET is from Microsoft. SQL Server is from Microsoft. So that time they suggested this one. If they are suggesting Java to develop an application, billing application, backend mostly Oracle. If application developed by Java, backend database mostly Oracle. If a front-end application they develop by using a .NET, mostly they will suggest SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server. So all your products information and what are all the products you are purchasing and the customer information, who is the salesperson, what is the store information, location information, all that information will be stored from this whenever you are doing a transaction already inside this particular SQL server, there is one database. Inside this database, there are several tables are available. In these tables, they have a data. Lot of tables are available. So whenever there is a transaction happen, the data will come and sit into the SQL server database. This is called OLTP database. OLTP stands for Online Transactional Processing Database. That means day to day live transaction. We don't know when the transaction is going to happen, because a customer will goes to the store. What time he will go? We don't know. Any time. Then when he is doing a transaction, immediately the data will come and store in the backend database. This is going to happen continuously. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to give this database to you. The database and sample data, everything I'm going to give to you. So in your project, your data source is this one only. As a data engineer, what you need to do? As a data engineer, whatever the data you have in this SQL Server database, you need to move this into the cloud environment. So inside the cloud, what you need to use? You have to use the take a blob storage. Let's, for example, in this SQL Server, in my source, I have 30 tables. So inside this blob storage, what I'm expecting from you, blob storage is nothing but storage account. I want you to create 30 CSV files. For each table, one file needs to be exported by using data factory. Yes. By using a data factory, you have to copy all these files from this on-premises SQL Server to cloud blob storage. So this scenario already we have discussed. How to connect to on-premises SQL Server and how to copy multiple tables into a cloud with a single pipeline. 30 tables means, are you going to take 30 copy data activities?
No,
you should not take. You have to take one copy data activity, but execute 30 times. How can you execute one activity multiple times using for each loop activity? How many times you are going to execute this for each loop activity? You need to pass that information. It might be 30 or 40 or 35. That information, how will you get? By using a lookup activity. So you have to take first lookup activity. Lookup activity will give you all the list of table names, which table name, which tables you want to copy. Okay. So that you need to pass as an input to for each loop activity. Inside the for each loop activity, you need to take a copy data activity. Got it? So then you can copy all the files into the blob storage. So inside the blob storage, you can create two containers. One is a raw container, another one is archived container you can create. Okay. So once these files completed, processing completed, then we will archive all the files into the archived folder. So first you need to move these files into the CSV files into the source is on-premises SQL Server contains some list of tables. I'm just giving rough number 30 tables. Okay, I want to bring this data into staging area. My staging area is storage account, a blob storage, nothing but a container. So two containers I have. One is raw, second one is archived. So raw container is, first you need to copy into the raw container only. How many? Whatever the 30 CSV files. Is this clear? So to implement this scenario, what are all the things required? First, you need to have on premises SQL server needs to be installed, then SQL server management studio, SQL server management studio is required, and the sample database, whatever I'm going to share, sample database. So this database you need to add into this SQL server. How to restore a database to your SQL server? So simply, let's for example, I have this SQL server. Okay, I have a database already available in the downloads. This is my database. Let me email this database. Let me copy into C drive. I will paste it over here. Okay, first you need to paste that database, whatever I'm going to give to you, into C drive. Then you can go to the SQL server already installed in your machine, right? So simply right click on the databases, restore the database. So how to download a SQL server and SQL management studio, already you are aware of that. Okay, so you can simply go to the SQL server, Google, download the SQL server. After downloading the SQL server, and if you are connected to the SQL server by using management studio, how to restore your databases, click on restore database and goes device to the device and browse it, go to the add, then goes to the C drive, select this source heritage data mart, click OK, and then click OK. It got failed. One second. I will remove these databases.
We can add now, sir. The database exists also, we can add one more database.
Or else let me do one thing. I will take a different server. I am taking this SQL server. Okay, I am going to restore the databases. Right click, restore device,
browse,
click add, C drive, click OK, click OK, click OK. Let me rename this one SRC Heritage Data Mart.
We can do.
No issues. Okay, this is how we can able to do. In your system, it will work, no problem. So this is my database. I have all this list of tables. All this list of tables. What I'm expecting from you, I want you to copy all these files, all these tables into blob storage, into raw folder, each table one CSV file. I hope this scenario already be discussed in the our trainings. So once the file, once the this is coming into your blob storage, based on our requirement for all these tables, whatever the tables we required, Let's, for example, we required a department employee, or generally, if you remember, my target means Synapse data warehousing is my target. Synapse dedicated SQL pool is my target. So here you are getting all the 30 tables from source, but in my target, I need only 6 tables only. In my target, I have only 6 tables. I want to load the data.
You need to convert external.
Okay. So first step, what you need to do is, I am expecting from all of you, copy these 30 tables as a 30 CSV files. Then after, out of these 30 tables, we want to bring only 6 tables. That means out of 30, we are not going to take only 6 tables. This is 6 tables information existing in these 30 tables. Let's, for example, in my target table, I have a employee table. Sorry, customer table. In my target means Synapse. Let's take one table. Table name is DIM customer. Okay, so DIM customer means, what are the information it has? Customer key, first name, last name, email address, phone number, address. This is how we have so much information in the DIM customer. When you are going to your source, in this source tables, customer information is not existing in only one table. It can have in multiple tables. For example, in one of the table, let me show you, person table. So simply, if you can see the data inside the person table, what information it has? First name, last name, middle name, email, promotion, whatever the information we have, this one only up to here. If you want a customer first name, last name, middle name, you can find here. But if you want a customer mobile number, that is in a different table. So you need to join these two tables. You got it? So that is the reason what I am expecting. That is a mapping document we need to create. That is a mapping document we need to create. Yeah. So mapping document means, before you are starting this ETL process, loading the data into your target, you need to prepare one mapping document. What is that mapping document? Is source, DB name, source, table name, source, column name, data type, next. Next, in place of source, target. What is this meaning of this document is? What is your target table? DIM customer. In a DIM customer, I have to load the data. Correct? For which column? First name column. What is the data type of that column? Varchar column. Okay? From Tooch database, my database is a target heritage. Mark. E database, where it is stored? It is in Synapse dedicated SQL pool. I'm talking about this one. This database. In this Synapse dedicated SQL pool, I have 6 tables. I'm discussing about one of the table, DIM customer table. Inside the dim customer table, I have one of the column, first name column. I need to load the data into this target heritage mart. Okay. And I want to load the data into dim customer table into this column. The data type of that column is varchar. So from where you can get the data for this table column, for this particular column. So that data we are getting from the source is from which table it is there? It is in the, what is the table name? Person table. Correct? First name column is in which database? Person database. Table name is person table. In which database it is? What is your database name? Source. Yeah. Is the column name in your source table? What is your column name? It's first name only. What is the data type? Obviously, it is a varchar only. You need to check what is the data type. You got it? This is for dim customer table. So this is how for in the dim customer table, whatever the columns you have. For all the columns, you need to design a mapping document. ఈ target dim customer table లోకి ఉన్న అన్ని columns లోకి data మనం ఏ table నుంచి తీసుకుంటున్నాం. Now coming to the mobile number. Okay, which table it is? Dim customer. In which database? What is the data type? Let's take integer. How will you get this mobile number? To get this mobile number, you have to go to which table? Person phone. That is the table you have. And what is the column name? Phone number column name? There is a phone number. Data type integer. What is the database? This database. This is how we need to prepare a document. Why we need to prepare this document? Then it is easy further process to do. Before you are going to develop anything, you need to prepare this document. This is called mapping details document. Now again you will go to the dim product table. This is for all the tables we are going to prepare a document. So first, what I am expecting from you, this is second step. This is second step. Why? After you are copying the data from this to here, when I am loading the data from this blob to here, then I need this document to understand which table contains which field. Then I can join those two tables to get the information, right? Phone number is in one table. Customer name is in another table. Then you need to join those two tables to get those two columns. Where we can do the joins? In between here. When we are using a, again here, data factory. Data flows I can use here. As a first step, you need to set up SQL Server here. All of you needs to be installed SQL Server and Management Studio in your local computer. And create one blob storage, two containers. One raw container, archived container. And I want you to create one pipeline, data factory pipeline, copying of these 30 tables or whatever, how many number of tables, all of the tables I want you to into the blob. Let's do one thing. For example, what are all the tables you have in this database? How will you get that information? If you want to get what tables you want to process, that is like you can write down one query also. It will give you all the list of tables in your database. Okay, let me use the ChatGPT. What I'm trying to ask ChatGPT, I want to find out, write a query to get all the list of table names in SQL database. Okay, so this is the query I am getting. Copy this. I am trying to run this query over here. In which database you are trying to get this information? In this database. Just keep the database name over here. Remove this. Oops. Under table type, let's see what is this condition will work. Execute only this part as well. So what's happening? It's giving all the list of tables, 91 tables. So some unnecessary tables are there, illustration and this passwords table, this view we don't have, we don't require. So in that kind of situation, to avoid those kind of tables, table type we can put. What condition we can give? Table type means user defined, we give DB. Okay, I will frame the question like this. Write a query, list of table names in SQL database, user defined tables. User defined means I created some tables. Okay. Okay, let me do one thing. How to filter only this list of tables, whatever you want, means put star, then we can see what information this information schema is giving. Then you can able to apply filter. Okay. Base table. Yeah. See, I don't want views. You know what is a view? I don't want these views. I just want only base table. So you can put a condition. Base table condition and execute. Now 71 tables are coming. Now we can put table name only. And you need this table schema as well. So take this table schema. Comma. Table. So in your lookup activity, you need to put this query. Because you need schema name dot table name. When you are passing to your source data set, right? You need to pass this schema name dot table. So this query you can keep, all the 71 will be executed. Clear? So today our expectation is this 30 tables needs to be processed into CSV files in the blob storage. Okay, I will share this video in the app and this file also. You can see that queries and all those things, and this video also you can able to do in the our app, eClasses app. Okay, let's start this. Once this is done, then we will prepare a mapping document. Once that is done, then we will move to the target. Then in this same project, another process is we have some two CSV files. Those we need to process by using Databricks. That is another scenario we can take. Then once this is complete, we will design some Power BI reports and dashboards. This is the flow of our, so our ending main goal is Power BI to design the reports and dashboards.
Sir, after converting 30 CSV files, we need to create the converted 30 external files. From the 30 external, we have to take
external tables we need to create. So that is the second step we can do. So first implement this scenario. Second step is creating the external dynamics. That is in the next session we can. So all these resources I will upload it to the app. Under the study free material, you can able to see these things.